That's really fantastic. Great job. And anytime, you know, somebody plays Ondine in public, I think it's quite an event.
It's
such, yeah, terrifying. But it's such a phenomenal work, you know, really beautiful. I wanted to there's something about the figuration that's important for people to know, which was that it actually appears incorrectly in the Duran edition. And I have a very close friend and colleague who wrote book on Ravel, book on Debussy, Paul Roberts, and we were conferring about this, and he had some interesting things to say, so I thought I just might mention what he said about the opening of this. Yes, the opening figuration is indisputably to be maintained throughout, and it comes directly from Ravel's corrections in his own copy of the first edition. I will give you the sources below. The problem arose because the autograph, now in Austin, Texas, contains Ravel's original error, and this was taken over into the first edition published by Durand. However, Ravel's own copy, with corrections in his own hand, survives and is in the Morgan Library in New York. I have seen it, and here are my scribbled notes. I have followed the usual practice of not counting the first two quarter upbeats as bar one, as the complete 4-4 bar. So he goes on to say, and basically what's happening here, and you have which edition? Yeah, I think. Right, so there, you know, here it's two versions. And what it is that the figuration is slightly different, but he maintains that that what Ravel intended was always for the figuration to be throughout the whole thing. So it changes and it goes da-da, you know, changes where the fast notes are sometimes. So anyway, I thought that was interesting, and you played that very, very well. It's very much a color piece, you know, so we're dealing with complex sounds and sonorities, and a beautiful melody. Do you know what the inspiration for the melody is? Yeah, from the poem, and in the poem there are references to water sprites and mermaids and things like this. And if you could imagine, what I would love to bring to the performance would be more of an imagination in terms of the line of the piece from a particular point of view, okay? So if you think of the tail of a mermaid, you know? You know that there's sort of movement, and then there's this fan and this kind of swirly kind of movement, and it's very, very sensuous, you know? Not that I've ever seen one, but, you know, that's sort of the image, you know, not up close and personal, but I want to bring a sensuality to the music. Now, there are certain factors that have to be in place in order for that to happen, okay? So we know that the figuration in this piece is monstrously difficult. I mean, very, very complex, okay? However, in the final, it's too loud, yeah. So it has to be very, 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 very soft.